protection while we sleep. We pray for healing, for prosperity. We pray for your mighty hand to ease our suffering. Yet love is way too much to give us lesser things. 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? What if trials of this life mercies in disguise? We pray for wisdom, your voice to hear. We cry in anger when we cannot feel you near. Doubt your love, as if every promise from your word is not enough. And all the while you hear each desperate plea, and long that we'd have faith to believe. 'Cause what if your blessings come seems to win? We know the pain reminds this heart that this is not our home. It's not our nights are what it takes to know you're near. What if my greatest disappointments or the aching of this life is the revealing of a greater thirst this world can't satisfy? And what if trials of this life, the rain, the storm, the hardest nights, are your mercies in disguise?
That God has something for us today. Amen? Do you believe on that? Hallelujah. The best clap of praise to God. So, if you have your Bible, and I would like to request everyone to stand on your feet as we give our reverence to the reading of the Word of God. Our text is found in the book of Philippians, chapter 1, verses 9 to 11. Philippians chapter 1, verses 9 to 11. Let us read with reverence to the Lord. And this I pray, that your love may abound still more and more in knowledge and all discernment, that you may approve the things that are excellent, that you may be sincere and without offense in the day of Christ, being filled with the fruits of righteousness which are by Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of God. May the living God bless his holy word. Upon reading it, shall we pray? Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus and by the power of the Holy Spirit, once again, I entrust everything to you. Lord, I pray that you will continue, Father God, Lord, to bless your word as you bless your people as well. I pray, hallelujah, that you will continue, Lord, to transform us according to your mercy and grace, according to your love to each and every one of us. May your words, O God, Lord, not only that every one of us will not only be a hearer of your words, but be a doer of your words, that we may able to apply your words, O God, every day of our lives. Thank you, Father God, for the lives of your people. I invoke your blessings to them. I invoke your healing to them. I invoke, O God, Lord, that you will supply all their needs according to your riches and glory in heaven. Lord, we thank you and we praise you for all the privilege, O God, hallelujah, of serving you. To God be the glory. In Jesus' name this we pray. And everyone says, amen and amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. So, I just want to give you the background of this text, wherein Apostle Paul writes a thank you note to the believers of the Philippians church for their help in his hour of need, and he uses this occasion to send along some instruction to the Christian unity. His central thought is simple. Only in Christ, your model in humility and service, you can enjoy a oneness of purpose, attitude, goal, and a labor of truth, which Paul illustrates in the Philippians church. Paul exhorts to the church that they should stand firm in their faith, that whatever circumstances that they are facing in their lives, they have to stand firm in their faith. And so he told them that be of the same mind, that they should have in the same faith, the same mind. And also that in times of trials and difficulties, that they have to rejoice in the Lord always, because this is the will of God. And also that he said in the book of Philippians that if you worry, if there are some troubles in your lives, in your family, or in the church, do not be anxious of anything, but in prayer, with thanksgiving and supplication, present your request to God, and He will give you the peace that passeth all understanding through Christ Jesus, who strengthens us. So these are the admonitions of Paul that he has given in the church of Philippians. And in connection with this, we as believers of the Lord, who are the believers of the Lord? The believers of the Lord are those who accepted Jesus as their Lord and personal Savior, and they continued and maintained their intimacy, their unbroken relationship with the Lord. They are the bride. The believers of the Lord are the bride that Jesus Christ is returning for. Do you believe that Jesus Christ is coming back again? And He is coming back for His bride. And we are the church of God. We are the bride of Christ. Amen? But we all know also that while we are waiting for the return, for the coming of the Lord, there's a lot of temptations. There's a lot of difficulties. There's a lot of pressures. There's a lot of trials and many more that we will be experiencing while we are here on earth. So while we are waiting for the Lord, for the coming of the Lord, let us have a goal to become a breakthrough believer. And this is gonna be our topic for today, a breakthrough believer. Okay, so what is breakthrough? When I look at the dictionary, I chose this meaning of breakthrough. It says, any significant or sudden advance, development, achievement, or increase that removes barrier to progress. I repeat, breakthrough means any significant or sudden advance, development, achievement or increase that removes a barrier to progress. So there's a word, sudden advance, development, increase, as well as achievement in order to produce progress. So that's the meaning. Now, what is a breakthrough believer? A breakthrough believer, by the way, our theme for our anniversary this coming September 13 is a seasons of breakthrough, arise, attack, advance. So we are looking forward that the Church of God, praise God, we are going to experience different breakthroughs in every area of our Christian life. Amen? Praise the Lord. So, breakthrough believer, he or she or someone who managed to survive from a strong storm, a big pressure, and a great obstacle of life. Meaning to say, she or he an overcomer. A breakthrough believer is someone who managed to survive from a strong storm, big pressure in life, or great obstacles of life. So like the example of Pastor Mark that I have heard last Sunday, he said that in order for a soil to become a good soil, it needs to be cultivated until it will be ready, prepared, or ready for work in order to raise good crops. Amen? So we want a farmer or anyone who wants to plant and who wanted to have a good, to raise a good crops, they are going to find a good soil. So in the same way it is applicable in our Christian life. We must have breakthrough in our attitude, in our character, in our morals, in our respect, maybe even common sense, trust, dignity, patience, integrity, and even love. Why? Because these are the things that money cannot buy. Do you agree with me? You cannot buy character. You cannot buy attitude, common sense. This is a long process as we go along with our right relationship with the Word of God, with the Lord Himself. Amen? So praise God. And on top of it, I believe that this is the will of God for us to carry these things in our everyday living. Now, let's look in verse 9. It says, their love abound more and more in two ways. In knowledge, which means the fear of God. Second, discernment, which is the perception of God. So these two, Paul is saying that their love, our love, should abound more and more in terms of knowledge, in terms of discernment. So in the book of Proverbs, chapter 9, verse 10 says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the Holy One is understanding. So your love is growing every day, not in the knowledge of men, but in the knowledge of God. You will discern if you are going in God's love every day. Paul prayed that your love abound more and more. It means that our love should be growing and expanding. That our love for God should be growing and expanding. If our love for God is not growing or maturing or expanding, eventually it will die. Okay? So love is progressive. Can you please tell to your neighbor, love is progressing. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Therefore, everything we do must be done with love. Do you agree with me? Amen. Everything that we do must be done with love. That's why when we come to the church, when we do something, when you come to the pulpit, praise the Lord, like, Sister Carol did a while ago, sang beautifully for the Lord. She sang beautifully for the Lord. And And that is her worship to God. Amen? Because we are not performing here. We are ministering. Amen? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So everything we do becomes our worship. Praise the Lord. We offer things to God with a heart of love, dedication, and commitment. So your love to God, to your family, to your co-workers, to your friends, to the ministry should be growing and expanding. Now, there are three areas where our love for God should be growing. Praise the Lord. So number one area is in the area of seeking God, which is our prayer. In the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 33 says, "But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." Prayer is as old as man. Prayer is as universal as religion. And it is important as breathing. Imagine a person who's not breathing, eventually he will die. Amen? So in the same way that if our prayer, we have no prayer at all, and you are a Christian, your relationship is going to die because there is no communication at all. So all men of faith practice prayer in some form. Because Buddhists, they pray, Muslim, they pray, Shintoism, all kinds of faith, they practice prayer in some form. Prayer is a man's acknowledge of a being higher than himself. That's why we pray. Most men try to pray, but sadly, only few know how to pray the way that, you know, the Lord taught us to pray. Our prayer life should be growing. It should be advancing and not retreating. So there are two kinds of prayer, and I would like to give you the two kinds of prayer. A prayer that does not reach God, and the other one is the prayer that does reach God. So both God, this is illustrated by our Lord Jesus Christ in the book of Luke. And it says that this is the parable of the Pharisee and the publican. The Pharisee are those people, members of the Jewish sect. They are considered as hypocritical person or a self-righteous person. Now, the publican is tax collectors. And those times, they were considered a sinner. And both men, the Pharisee and the publican, went into the same place. At the same time, for the same purpose, they prayed. The Pharisee prayed in his religious pride, expecting God to answer because he thought himself worthy. He said, the Pharisee stood and prayed. God, this is the way he prayed. God, thank you that I am not like other men. They are extortioners. They are adulteries, or even as this tax collector. Lord, I have so much good works. He said, I fast and I give. This is the kind of prayer that does not reach God. You know why? Because it was a self-righteous prayer. Now, let us look at the publican prayer. A sinner and a begging of mercy. He said, he prayed to the Lord, God, be merciful to me because I am a sinner. So this is the kind of prayer that does reach God. God doesn't need a proud mouth that speaks much about of our accomplishment. Our achievements and accomplishments are good, but it doesn't our qualification in order to have a right relationship with the Lord. Amen. Our sincerity, our true heart, and our true motive of our coming to the Lord is what God really is looking to us. And it says that being humble is more important than being wise, because God doesn't need to hear your boasting, but He needs to hear your total dependence on God. He wants to hear that we admit that apart from God, we cannot do anything. Amen? So, a breakthrough believer have a lifestyle of being prayerful that makes him a prayerful believer. Amen? Hallelujah. So the second one that we need that we need to grow is in the area of searching God, which is your Bible reading. Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12 says, "For the word of the Lord is alive and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of soul and spirit and of joints and marrow. It is a discerner of thoughts and the intents of the heart." So our appetite for the word of God should be growing also. Amen? So that's where our discernment of perception about God will continue to grow. We have to spend quality time in the reading of the Word of God, because God will speak to us through His words. Amen? Hallelujah. So many times, I believe that many times we experience that we receive confirmation or the words from God through the Word of God, through reading the Bible. So in times of loss, in times of trials and difficulties, uncertainties, the Word of God is our strong weapon, because of God's promises are yes and amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. From His words, we can see the plan of God and His purpose in our lives, because God's plan is always perfect. Do you believe on that? That the plan of God is always perfect. Hallelujah. And then it says that He's doing something for you when sometimes the process is painful and hard. But don't forget that when God is silent, God is doing something on behalf of His people. So therefore, spending time in reading the Word of God should be consistent, should be progressing, something that we have to become hungry and thirst for more of Him to nourish our spiritual being. Amen? Praise the Lord. So there was a story. There was a certain man who was trying to buy a home in one community. He had told to the Lord from the beginning, "Lord, this is your project. This is going to be your home. And so I am not going to worry about and prep or connive and manipulate to get that home in my name. I want it very much, as you know, Lord, but I refuse to let it the God of my life. I leave it with you to take care of any barrier." So this is how he prayed to the Lord for the home that he wants to get. As this man trusted fully in the Lord, however, he and his family saw of each of these barrier or obstacles removed one by one. Then on the very last day, when he and his wife were getting dressed to go down and sign the papers or documents on the home that the loan company called, "I'm sorry," the loan officer said, "but we've determined that your salary is insufficient, and therefore we won't be able to loan the money." So at that point, many of us would have exploded with anger, probably, and depression. But this man, in the midst of crushing disappointments, remember his agreement with the Lord. After he hung up the phone, he went to his knees and said, "Lord, I've said all along, this is going to be your home, and if you don't want me to have, so be it." He surrendered his desire to the Lord. And then he said that he then He said to the Lord, I refuse also to be upset about it. He then rested his spirit. He recognized that God was God, period. Within a few hours, his phone rang again. Same loan company, same loan officer. Something has happened for the first time in my experience here, the man on the phone said. We'd made a mistake. In fact, we made some miscalculations in our computations. Your salary is certainly sufficient. Do you still want the home? Amen. Praise the Lord. Shall we give the best clap of praise to God? There are times in our prayer that we cannot see the answer instantly. Amen. And there are times that you can see that one by one, the barrier, the obstacle has been gone. But later on the last day, like what had happened to this man, there is going to be a bad news. But praise be to God. Then when we seek the will of God, when we are growing in the area of searching God and His words and His decision for us, God will make a way when there seems to be no way. Amen? God is always in control, and in all our behalf, God is doing something great for the lives and for the benefits of His people. Amen? Praise the Lord. And also, we must be growing in the area of serving God. This is our demonstration of love. It is possible to serve without love, but it is impossible to love without serving Him. Amen? So again, I repeat. In the area of serving God, this is our outward demonstration of love to Him. It is possible to serve God. It is possible to serve God without love, but it is impossible to love without serving Him. So speaking of serving God, when you serve God, these things will happen. Serving God always involves sacrifice. Do you agree with me? This is sacrifice coming to the church right now. Amen. I believe that the weather is so kind of weird nowadays. They said that this is the hottest summer in Hawaii. Some people are saying that this is the first time that they experience this kind of weather in Hawaii. But nevertheless, we choose to come. Amen. And to worship the Lord because we love the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. And what is sacrifice? Sacrifice is the act of giving or giving up something that you want to keep, especially in order to get or to do something else to help someone, willing to do an extra mile for the Lord and for the expansion of His kingdom. So serving God motivates you to strive for more of Him. Amen? Serving God motivates you to strive for more of Him. Praise the Lord. Motivation. Praise the Lord. That when we in love for the Lord, we are going to do what pleases to Him. Amen? Praise the Lord. So, you strive to make a strenuous effort toward any goal, to try every hard to do or achieve something, doing things with an excellent attitude. Say it with me, excellent attitude. Amen. Praise the Lord. So you are giving your time, your energy, your talent, effort, and everything. Hallelujah. As part of your sacrifices, as part of your motivation to strive for more of Him. Serving God will also include suffering. Are you willing to suffer for the sake of the gospel? Who are willing to suffer for the sake of the gospel? Only few hands. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you for that. Amen. Defending the word of truth in spite of all odds, persecution, criticism, and many more. You will experience pain, illness, imprisonment, isolation, or injury. That's exactly what Paul had experience during of his mission in different churches, praise the Lord, including the Church of Philippians. So Christian life is not a bed of roses. It is a life full of challenges, and at the same time, a life full of satisfaction. Okay? So, please listen to me on this. It is a life full of challenges, but on the other hand, it is also a life full of satisfaction. Why satisfaction? Because if you know your mission, if you understand your mission, your existence here on earth, hallelujah, you will understand why all those things you are experiencing. Amen? Hallelujah. So, you will understand your purpose, your destiny, and in spite of your situations. So being a follower of Christ is not easy. It's not easy. Praise the Lord. Because being a follower of Christ, being the head of different ministry, is not easy. No? It's not easy to become a chairman of the praise and worship. It's not easy to become the chairman of children ministry, hula dance maybe, or the ushering ministry, food ministry. Amen? It's not easy because you are dealing with people. Amen? But thank God for those people who commit themselves in the service of the Lord. Amen? So being a follower of Christ is not easy. Breakthrough believer always love God, and their love is growing, maturing, and expanding. They seek God all the time and search God and serve Him with all of their heart, with all of their mind, with all of their strength, and everything they have. Do you agree with me? Amen. Praise the Lord. So in verse 10 says, their approval of things is excellent. So what are the things that need excellent approval? For sure, it's not worldly thing. That's why discernment is important. Gathering is an excellent thing. Why? Because in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25 says, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. Giving to the Lord or helping one another is also an excellent thing. When you give, God will open the windows of heaven. Do you believe on that? To pour out the abundance of His blessings. And God loves the cheerful giver. Please tell to your neighbor, God loves a cheerful giver. Amen? Without reluctancy, without forcing, without any negative, mind, praise the Lord, but with a cheerful heart, we are willing to give it to the Lord and to those people that we are helping. Growing also is an excellent thing. When we grow in our spiritual life, we will be fruitful. Amen? Because when we are growing in our spiritual life, we will be fruitful. People around us will see the difference because you are shining and the glory of the Lord is being seen in our lives. Amen? There is a transformation. There is changes. Hallelujah. Generosity is excellent. Gentleness is also an excellent thing. Gladness is excellent. Godliness is an excellent thing. Goodness is an excellent thing. Glorifying God is an excellent thing. Amen? So the more you worship God, the less you will worry. So there is, a secret. We are all prone. We are all vulnerable to worry. Why? Because we live here on earth full of anxieties, full of uncertainties. But the Word of God is reminding us that the more you worship God, the less you will worry. You will feel more patient and less pressured. Amen? Hallelujah. Now, in the book of Daniel, chapter 6, verse 3 says, Then this Daniel distinguished himself above the governors and satraps because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king gave thought to setting him over the whole realm. So these things we can see that Daniel demonstrated a life of excellent spirit under a cruel and ungodly king, Nebuchadnezzar. And yet, despite of the situation, he kept his faith and his integrity, and his life was a living testimony of power and salvation. So if they can see, if the people around us see an excellent spirit, even your enemy will become your friend. Do you believe on that? Amen? Hallelujah. So we need an excellent spirit in our Christian life. As the bride of Christ that Jesus Christ is returning for, praise God, we should have an excellent spirit that people around us would see in us. So be an excellent believer in the eyes of God. Can you please tell to your neighbor, be an excellent believer in the eyes of God. Amen. Hallelujah. And of course, not only in the eyes of God, but also in the eyes of man. Amen. Because it will be, you know, automatic. It's going to be seen by the people around us. Amen. Hallelujah. Verse 10, they are sincere and without offense till the day of Christ. Their service is sincere and their testimony is above reproach. So breakthrough believer is someone whose life is sold out for God and always willing to do extra mile to God or to serve God, and at the same time preserve his testimony at all time. He was not involved in any, or he was not involved nor create trouble. He or she never participates in gossiping, hearsay, disunity, or anything that causes a certain group, ministry, or organization to be disunited. He or she is faithful, loving believer who always preserves the unity in the midst of chaos and in the midst of trouble. Amen? Praise the Lord. He or she is someone you can trust and rely on when needs arises. He or she focus not on the situation of the surrounding, but on the coming of the Lord. So the bride of Christ, a breakthrough believer, is not focused not on the situation of the surroundings, but he is focused on the coming of the Lord. Hallelujah. So you are not distracted by this world, but you kept your faith in God and in his glorious return. So our sincerity in loving and serving God will bring us until the day of Christ. This is until his second coming. It is really important for us to love and serve God and maintain our personal walk with God with holiness and integrity. Is it important to maintain, praise the Lord, our personal walk with God with holiness and integrity? Absolutely, yes. Amen. So Jesus is coming back again, and we need to be sincere without offense till the day of Christ. Many will throw all kinds of dirt against you. Many will say all kinds of bad words against you. There are people who will make gossip of you. Some will try to put you down. Some of you will experience tremendous pressure from job. Others will experience painful situations. But in spite of what the devil is trying against you, you will never be moved. Amen? You will never be dismayed. Hallelujah, for the Lord who called you is a faithful God. Amen. Hallelujah. The best clap of praise to the Lord. Because the Lord who called you is faithful. He will defend you. He will strengthen you. He will with you all the way. Amen. Hallelujah. Again, a clap of praise to our God. So be encouraged to grow in love for God and serve Him faithfully with gladness in your heart. Maintain an excellent spirit in all circumstances. Be always sincere and without offense until His second coming. Amen. So in verse 11 says, they are filled with the fruits of righteousness which are by Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. So what are the fruits of righteousness? The fruit of righteousness is the product of the divine life in those who have been justified in Christ. It's the work of Christ as we abide in Him. It means that fruit is being produced not by any human standard, but by way of abiding Christ. Fruit of righteousness is a product of God's discipline to His children. It is a painful process of shaping our character and attitude for our own good and for His praise and for His glory until the second coming of the Lord. It is a way of God's training to His people to be more humble, submissive, and strong in the Lord. In other words, you sow peace and not trouble. Amen. Nagtatanim ka ng kapayapaan, hindi ng kaguluhan. Amen. You maintain peace and live in peace. Amen. Praise the Lord. Come on, shall we give the best clap of praise to God? Because Jesus Himself is the Prince of Peace, lives in you and keep shaping you. Amen. Hallelujah. When you abide, you humble. When you abide, you submit and you surrender and yield to Christ. Your fruit is the result of your attachment with Him. Our fruits, our character, our attitude, our reactions will be the result of our attachment with the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. So our fertile soil, which is our heart, in our sincere and consistent commitment or communion with the Lord, will become rooted and therefore produce fruit of righteousness. In John chapter 15 verse 4 says, Jesus says to His disciples, abide in Me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abide in the vine, thus neither can you unless you abide in Me. Meaning to say, apart from God, we cannot do anything. Apart from the Lord, praise God, we will not bear a fruit of righteousness. Amen? Because the more we come into the presence of God, the more we commune into the presence of God, praise God, we will be like Him. Amen? Hallelujah! The best clap of praise to God. So, be filled with the fruit of the Spirit. Keep abiding, keep surrendering, and keep yielding. And in verse 11 says, that everything they do is for the glory and praise of God. Hallelujah. Everything. Take note the word everything. Everything means everything we do should be for the glory and praise of God. Amen. Hallelujah. The best clap of praise to God. So our worship, our praise, our service, our giving, our work, everything should be for the praise and glory of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. So, my brethren, it is very important for us that we should be reminded of the teaching or the admonition of this text wherein in times of our difficulties, in times of uncertainties, in times of trouble and disunity, always look unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Amen? Because if you are going to look at your right hand, left side, or maybe in the front or at the back, praise God, you will be, you are going to be affected. But praise God, if we are going to be that Jesus Christ is the only object of our worship, we will not be, go into the right, wrong way. Amen? God is going to direct us in the right path wherein we are going to become a breakthrough believer. Amen? Hallelujah. So, in conclusion, a breakthrough believer's love for God abound more and more. So you will discern, you will know if your love for God is growing every day. Amen? Because it will be growing, your seeking for God, your searching for God, your serving for God. Amen? Hallelujah. Breakthrough believer is sincere and without offense until the day of Christ. And also, breakthrough believer has an excellent spirit. Amen? Breakthrough believer is filled with the fruits of righteousness which are by Christ Jesus. Breakthrough believers do everything for the glory of God. And breakthrough believer is the bride that Jesus is returning for. Amen? Hallelujah! The best clap of praise to the Lord. I hope that we get something today. And I hope and I pray that we are going to manifest, the admonitions that Paul has given to us wherein we have to desire to become a breakthrough believer, an overcomer wherein God is going to be glorified and exalted when we became an overcomer. Amen. Praise the Lord. You may stand up, please. And let us continue to worship the Lord. Hallelujah.